To how to, for example, learning resources. In this session we'll be doing Cloudera quick start VM installations. The reason we are doing this quick start VM because we are going to do all the our training of Hadoop related professional training, then Spark training, the CCA 175 Cloudera developer certification, Cloudera data engineer certification, CCP 575, etc. We'll be doing using this Cloudera quick start VM. Even if you are not using this product, then you want to install this quick start for your own practice, you can use it this, and we will provide this PDF as well, so you can download it from the description section of the video in the wherever it is uploaded and wherever you are watching it. So let's start the installation. Okay, and we'll be using version 5.7, which is latest available on the Cloudera website. Okay, so now system requirement, there are main like Hadoop is quite heavy product, so we need some good system. So if this training is completely on Windows operating system, so if your Windows operating system, it is required to be have 64-bit VM player, virtual machine player. We will be using VM image, so virtual machine VMware product is required, so we are using 7.x version. From where to download, we will show you in the few minutes. And the VM needs 4GB RAM at least to run your cloud Hadoop framework. It requires 4GB RAM at least. So it is expected your OS has minimum 8GB RAM available, so you can practice, otherwise it is not possible to run this product. So minimum 8GB RAM is required, and we suggest you go for 60GB RAM if possible. Upgrade your system, it's very it's not very costly rather than buying a new system. Okay, so now host OS must be support hardware virtualization. What happens is actually sometimes by default it is not enabled hardware virtualization, so we need to do this. So I'll show you, because many times like this is the very small problem, but many of learners are facing this problem. So we'll show you how to solve this problem if you are facing this problem. So download link of quick start VM is here, so you just click on this and it will go here. So let me show you this browser. This is the cloud quick start VM image, sorry, screenshot. So here you select the quick start download version 5.7 and select the platform. You can select here. Okay, so this is refreshing. Okay, so now we are going to do the VMware and download now. Just once you click on download now, it will come up with the form. You just need to fill in this required things. It's very basic, it's like it's your description why you are going to use this product. Okay, so we have already downloaded this file actually. So and the downloaded file would be okay, so once you download it will download a zip file. I'll show you. Let me go here in my machine, drive installable Cloudera 57. So you will be having this zip Cloudera Kickstart VM 5.7.0 zip file would be downloaded. Okay, so now next we are going to download the VM player, which is needed, correct? So this is the player in which this image would be we are playing. That's the reason we need it, and this is provided by VMware. So you can go directly VMware site from there and you can download it. So now again you have to select the proper software. So we are going to use it for Windows operating system, so Windows 64-bit operating system, and the size is 77 MB, so it's not very big. Download it, and once you download it, it's a very simple download. Okay, so now you should have downloaded files, and you could have these two files available. Okay, VM player 7.1.exe and this is now first install the VM player. Very simple, just double click the keep pressing next. Once this is the exe, just install it into the VM. You use it anything you install on the Windows machine. So we are not going to do the steps to how to install it. Very simple and very simple. So we don't want to waste your time, so you can do it your own installation. So once you have installed, okay, this VM player, you would see this image in your desktop. Okay, so this is similar here, you can see here on my desktop. Okay, so now let's move ahead. Okay, so this is the image you have. So now we have VM player installed. Now till now we are like just installed a VM player. Now installing quick VM Cloudera. Okay, so now unzip the CloudEra file, quick start VM, and it will take quite a long time because the file size is very big. It's a more than 3.5 GB. Okay, so you can see here in a 4 GB even, correct? You can see here the zip file is around 4.76 GB, 5 GB. So it will take long time. So you just 7-zip or any archiver extract here, you can extract it, okay, just by clicking here. So I'll cancel this because I've already extracted this. So let me delete this path just created now, so I don't need it. So I have extracted this and I pushed the everything. I renamed this for folder, and with quick VM 57_257 is version and 2 is my second installation, so that's the reason I have given. So you can give your own name, whatever you want it. So and if you want to follow with me, so just keep this the same name if possible. Okay, so now I have my folder quick VM extracted here. So you can see after extraction everything would be look like this in your local machine. Okay, now go to this VMX files. Okay, this is the configuration file about this image. So there are some properties defined, and this is very important for you before installing to do this thing. Otherwise it could be a problem. If everything's fine on your machine, then it's okay, but if you want to debug, if there is any problem, then how would you debug it? Okay, so there is a VMX file. Inside there is a one properties defined, message dot auto answer equal to true. If you auto answer, then whatever what happens, like whatever questions while starting the image by VM player would be always true. So what happens, like if there is any error in the system, it will not be shown to you. So what we suggest, go to this file in the installation directory. Okay, vmware.vmx file, this is my VMX file. Open with any editor if you have. So I have edited this, and search for control F auto answer something. Okay, so this is true, just comment it. We don't want to auto answer. If you auto answer it, then it would be a problem, so don't auto answer it. Okay, so now we have marked this auto answer, so you can read the explanation as well why we have marked. This is very good, you should do this always. Okay, wherever whatever images you are using it, it's not a specific to CloudEra Quick Start VM, because it helps you to debug. If everything if anything goes wrong, you are not able to understand what is happening, and this is the case which we will be facing. Even I faced in my laptop, because by default hardware virtualization is not enabled. So in that case we need it. So now start the VM player just by clicking on the icon on your desktop. So I'll go on my desktop, click here, double click, because I have installed the VM player. Okay, I have already like lot of VM already installed, so that's fine. Actually we will be keep adding. So this is the number of VM you edit. So whenever you are starting practicing new things and you want to clean setup, you can use the exist like VM image and start doing the things. Okay, so it won't be just because the VM image you start, then only it is your system, otherwise it's just a configuration. That's fine. Okay, so now in your case, if you are plainly starting first time, so you won't see anything other than home here. Okay, so now like I have shown here, like this is the blank image you can see, kind of thing. Okay, this is the screenshot I have taken. So open a virtual machine. Okay, just go here and open a virtual machine. Okay, so this is the VM player which can play your virtual machine. So I'll click on open virtual machine, go to the location like CloudEra 57_2 and select this file. Okay, similarly, okay, I have shown here VMX file. Now you can see this is the VMX file we are going to select. Okay, now select it. Now you can see CloudEra VM added left hand side. So open it. Now CloudEra Quick VM is added here. Just rename it. Okay, go to settings, and I wanted to rename it first. Okay, give me a minute. CloudEra Quick VM _2, something we can give name. Okay, okay, so I have given the name. Okay, just minute. Now you can see that has been added here, and okay, it's saying play the virtual machine directly, but before that I wanted to show you something important for us. Okay, so by default it is 4 GB RAM, correct? It's a configured. My machine has 8 GB RAM, 16 GB RAM, so I can change this setting if I wish, or you can just start, because 4 GB is enough to start the virtual machine. Okay, and if you have a 16 GB RAM, then I would suggest you start with the like 8 GB RAM. And how to change the 8 GB, just go here and update it here, so it will 8 GB, correct? Now here you can see, here you can put the data as well. So now it shows 8 GB. Okay, and here you can select edit virtual machine setting as well, direct button here. Okay, so now you can click on play virtual machine. That's the point where you are starting a virtual machine first time. So let's do this, and it will take around I would say, do you want to try connect with virtual machine? So every time you just answer it yes. Okay, that's the reason I would tell you auto answer should be disabled, otherwise you don't know. So this image will take some time, so meanwhile I will go somewhere other in the PDF at the below section. Okay, so now important point where most of the time this virtualization starting fails. If your Windows machine enabled with virtualization support, then in few minutes VVM player will start. Otherwise virtualization is not enabled, you will see the following pop-up. So if auto answer is not commented, you won't see this pop-up. So if you see this pop-up and some this kind of information, this host support, Intel VTX, Intel, if it is an Intel machine or based on some other processor you are using it. Okay, so so this kind of pop-up you see and this kind of messages you see. So how to solve this problem? Just to go to your problem, you just go to your Windows machine BIOS setting. A BIOS setting, you just need to find it based on your laptop which you are using it, what key would help you to go into. In my case, F8 key is enough. While booting up the operating system, I'll just click F8 and it will enter into the BIOS setting. But in your case it could be different, so you have to find it out. It's a very basic, you can just Google it for your laptop or your operating system, how to enter into the BIOS setting. You go to in the BIOS setting and go into the system configuration. Here you can see in system configuration, look for the virtualization technology, and in here you can see in my laptop previously it was disabled. Now virtualization technology, I have changed it enabled. Okay, just using up arrow or down arrow you can change it, and some screen while VM start it will take little longer. So that's enough to do this thing, and then again go back and start your virtual machine, virtual player again with the your because this setting I have already done in my it was just pop-up. Okay, so like to upgrade the VM player, I don't want to upgrade again and again all the time, so I've just say no. Okay, so now some screen while VM start, it takes 5 minutes and depends on the like I have just started and we are continuing. So that is the virtualization technology you need to enable. Okay, and so now let's go to the our VM image. It's just getting started, so it is not yet started. Okay, so let it come up and then we'll continue again. So this is the image you can see here, like screenshot I have taken it from 5.4.2, but it is almost similar for 5.7. so this is Cloudera's background because they are providing this image. Okay, so then we'll go and the further inside that. Let it be start first. Okay, meanwhile I wanted to tell you, like Hadoop exam has various certifications for the Hadoop and the Spark certification and the training as well. Hadoop HBase and Spark training and Amazon web service certification, SES certification, data science certification, HBase certification, Azure certifications, cloud Oracle certification, we have Java certification as well. So and in mobile certification we have launched. So you can see all the products listed here from the all products, and you can start using this product once you subscribe it. And I would suggest you go through this hardtipexam.com at least once to understand what we provide and how it could help you in your career. So we have more than 11,000 subscribers as of now. So you can imagine, like, the services provided by us is being used. So if you want to get the update email, just subscribe here. And if you are looking for some other training and exam which is not listed here, you can just request it from here. So we'll try to match your requirement if possible. Okay, so that's all. And let's the VM image is trying to keep coming. So this kind of if everything goes well, you can see this kind of images are screens coming up from the your virtual machine. Okay, so I've started this virtual machine with 8 GB RAM, so it would be little faster, and the amount of memory you provide, it would be faster. Okay, so there are some reason as well, like why you need to run on 8 GB RAM, like at least because you want to use Cloud Era Manager, then it is needed at least 8 GB RAM. Okay, so now my virtual machine has started, and you can see it has already installed many required components like Eclipse. It's, if you are going development in Java, then you can use it. Cloud Era Enterprise Edition, Cloud Era Express is here. Okay, so this all things are there, and this is the browser coming up. So you can see here all the Spark browser, Hadoop browser, already all the required services also started by this Cloud Era. So you need not to worry too much about the installation of the individual component. The most important component is Apache Hue. So this is again developed by the Cloud Era itself, so you can use this Hue and go inside this. So let's see here. Okay, so the important thing here, the password and username. Most of the time we get the query, what is the username and password? So it's very simple. If you have read the Cloud Era website, Cloud Era, that's all. Just and sign in. It's remember, so you don't have to type again and again. So now you are inside this, and here you can see the Hive Query, Impala DB, PicQuery, Job Designer, DB Browser, HB, Scope Transfer, Metadata. So this UI is very helpful actually. Do many things. So this Hue is very important components, how to use workflows created kind of thing. So this is our entire training. If you see here, like CCP, CCA and everything we provide based on the Cloud Era Quick VM. So you can understand more and more. And even if you want to browse the HDFS file systems, like right now we don't have any files, so you can just create a new file here or directory here. I would say Hadoop exam is my directory name. I just want to create it. So you can create in HDFS very simply. Now this directory is created, it is on HDFS file system under managed by the Hadoop itself. So this way you can create using this, rather than using the lot of command and everything, you can do this. So this is the same screenshot I have taken from 5.4 version. Now VM up and running, and you can do how to shut down, that is the questions here. Once your VM started, you just wanted to shut down, just go to here and suspend the guest, restart the guest, shut down the guest. So this is the guest, correct? On the my host operating system, this operating system is a guest. Okay, so I just want to shut down. So you can start practicing using our training material from this VM. So thanks for watching, and I hope you like this. And we are going to come up with the many new trainings of this Hadoop, and this is the entire portfolio we have in the hadoopexam.com, so you can use it for your learning purpose and grow your career. Okay, so we'll help, and we are providing our all the materials as a lifetime accessible. Once you subscribe it, you can get all the updates on the same product on same machine, lifetime accessible. Okay, so there is no access restrictions, you can see. So that would help you to, like, if we are keep updating our products, and you can get the updates as well without any additional charge. So if you are watching this video on YouTube, I would suggest please subscribe on YouTube channels below, so that we can anytime upload new videos, you can get the notifications. That's what we wanted you to know. And that's the way you can keep in touch with us, and we will try to provide the material as fast and as good possible, as good as possible. So please help us and subscribe. Thank you, and provide the feedback as well, so we can improve our each new upcoming product, so you will get better quality day by day. Thank you. Thanks for watching.